Electrum. But it only existed in D&D. Got him that time. Let's move on before he respawns. Oh shit.
The incessant clamor of the undead at the gate finally stops, and you come through the gate. It is a relief to finally... Good, very good. The tunnel is cleared then, yes? Akuzri is eternally grateful. He can make it back to... Yes. This one saw the prince with his own eyes. He is no longer Naaman, though. He has been raised and possessed by some... No one knows. But if destroying Marbrook were his goal, you would expect the prince to remain, yes? No. The prince plans... You must consult with Indenir. He has already been considering this question. Akuzri must warn you. Indenir is very strange, even for a Bosmer. But this one has never met an elf with such understanding. Indenir, the tunnel is finally clear. Akuzri will return to Malbrook and send soldiers to reinforce this location.
Yes, yes, that makes sense. Perhaps it's better if I go out into the pass and try to discover why Naaman ordered the undead to attack in the first place.
Hold on, yes, don't go alone.
Both of you go. Find out what Naaman is planning and report to Marbrook. Don't try to do all this on your own. And of course, may bright moons light your path.
Hey.
I appreciate the main sentiment and the support of the Dominion, but ultimately, it falls on us to protect Valenwood. Since the Sylvanar's death, I get the sense that Queen Irene feels she owes us something. But we Bosmer are not helpless. Of course not. And I'm grateful for your assistance. It's true that I can't do this alone. I just think marching the entire army into the forest would be a mistake. I don't think it's that simple. The Shade has assumed Naaman's form. It retains some of Naaman's memories. But it's a different entity now. Drilladun Pass is old. Many Bosmer died here, and some cannot be raised by any magic. They are the accursed souls who violated the Green Pact, Come with me and we will try to commune with them. Oh, there are many ways. Perhaps they cut down a tree or ate berries from the local plants. Sometimes their intentions were good, but Valenwood is unforgiving. If they violate the pact, no, they are tethered to their remains, and they cannot pass into death, nor can they return to life. Thus they remain witness to all that transpires among living and dead alike. I've been underground too long. I can't wait to get back out into the forest.
What do you want?
What do you eat then if you can't eat berries?
I think we're in luck. Though most of the local wildlife has fled from the undead, the torchbugs have remained. Many people do not... I can ask one of them to lead you to the remains of the cursed dead. If you can find the skulls or some such, bring them to the stone table. I will go ahead and prepare so... Let's see if I can speak to this one. Come here, little one. Yes, that would be so helpful. Thank you. Off it goes. Follow it to find the skulls and then meet me at the stone table.
Oops, I lost him.
You who were condemned, hear me. Your only hope of being released is to tell us why the dead have been risen.
Ha! We need no release. The Shade of Naaman heralds a new age. An age where we will be restored. And you are the ones who will be judged.
Hold on. How do you know that? Did the Shade actually tell you that?
He doesn't have to. When the forest is transformed, who do you think will inhabit the Shadowwood? We will.
Naaman does not have the power to release any of you, but I do. Help us and you'll have your chance at freedom.
I'll tell you, don't listen to that fool. The Shade seeks to corrupt the forest, to create a new realm. It's called the Shadow Wood.
I suspected something like this. It explains what we've seen. The Shade of Naaman does not seek destruction. It seeks transformation. We need... Not easily, but I promise them. Since...
We told you what you wished to know. Little good that it would be. I shifted, which is strictly forbidden by the Green Pact. I was cocky, did it to prove that I could, that's all. It was a mistake. I understand that now.
It's odd to watch the slaughter of your people through the empty sockets of your own skull. My family was slaughtered by the Wood Orcs, and I burned down their village, every last structure, every last tree for revenge. I shouldn't have harmed the forest. I should have rallied my...
Fool, do you not see what's upon you? Look around. The Shadow will consume all Tamriel and usher in... The other races laugh at us. Why do we depend on them for wood we could easily take for ourselves? The Green Pact is for the weak.
It's odd to watch the slaughter of your people through the empty...
My family was slaughtered by the Wood Orcs, and I burned down their village, every last structure, every last tree for revenge.
It pains me to see the forest suffer like this. I can sense the green itself calling out for vengeance. Glad that's done. The pleading of the condemned is almost too much to bear. One way or another, I won't question your judgment. Their fates are decided, but the fate of Valenwood is what concerns me. These shadow rifts the skulls mentioned, we must close them quickly. I haven't quite figured that out. I can feel them, though. They feel like wounds in the forest. I have some small ability to mend the green, but it requires all of me. I'm going to need... We will cleanse the forest or die trying.
I don't plan on dying, mate.
However many rifts they open, I will close them all, every one. Such foul creatures in my forest will not be tolerated. Whatever it takes.
Okay. There you going? Hopefully not too tired. Early where you are.
Leave the Shadow Rifts alone or you will suffer.
Who would have thought fried tomatoes would be so... Oh, good. Tastes pretty good, but I think the healing ability would be so good. They look undead themselves.
Living one, you meddle with forces you cannot understand.
Just screw yourself.
Such foul creatures in my forest will not be tolerated.
For a second there.
You go too far. Now you will experience the shadow wood for yourself.
What foul magic is this? Is this the shadow wood? It is. This is what the shape... I do not know. I never imagined this realm would be so elaborate. How could he create this? Where does he get such? Perhaps there is a gateway back to our realm, back to Valenwood, some place where life and death intersect.
Hello?
Jesus, that extra health has lost a lot.
Getting a bit dicey.
It seems our circumstances are even worse than I imagined. The corruption of the Shadow Wood expands across the forest. I fear it's too late to contain it. I know not, but I certainly aim to find out. First, though, you must report what we've learned to Marbrook. We need to at least keep them informed. Don't worry, when the time is right, the forest will help me find you.
Don't take long. We must press on with our efforts.
Yeah. can't believe my eyes. The undead are actually receding. For a while there, I thought you were making a last stand here. Then it's as the main suggested. Magical forces are at work here that we can't fight with sheer numbers. I shouldn't be surprised. I'm just glad we have you and Indin. I wish this victory didn't feel so hollow. Other than keeping the undead at bay, it seems there's little we can do to battle this darkness. We are here to support you and That's Indin for you. Always trying to shoulder all the burden himself. We can't let him get away with that, though. There's whispers that Naaman's actually been raised as a lich. One of the spinners said Naaman was a lich and was at Hectorhaim. You and Indinir should go there too when time allows. For now, though, Indinir's bound to be in Verand Morass or Dreadful Lane. You should catch up. Indinir's a real piece of work, isn't he? I always thought he was half mad. They say he has the green in his blood, but most things that man does. Mad as he is, I thought he came from the Bramblebreach clan, but some said it was Woodhearth. Truth is, no one knows. Even heard he was raised by an old Grot oak, cradled in its roots, weaned on the dew from its...
I'd be completely surprised.
I'm glad you're here. I've been trying to help these poor people, but it's futile. There's a blight here that's turned them into rabid beasts. Undoubtedly, it's the corruption of Prince Naaman's shade, spreading through the forest and somehow affecting... Long ago, before the Green Pact, the Standing Stones were used to protect the people from the aggression of the forest. If we can activate this... We must work quickly, my friend. Clearly, the blight doesn't affect all Bosma. But if anyone wanders into this area, I suspect there is a strong chance they will become afflicted. If we forbid a scouting party, I can't be sure. But I suspect it's our people's connection to the Green that allows us to be infected. Other races will be immune. It also seems that some Bosma can resist the blight.
Aren't I high up?
Even the water here seems to be somehow tainted.
Oh.
must work quickly, my friend. Clearly, the blight... Corruption has spread to these plants as well. It's like they're dead, but not dead at the same time. think I can actually sense the blight attempting to corrupt my mind. I've never felt anything like this. Ifris bodes. The corruption is coming from the den of the eldest. We need to get there, quickly. If the eldest has been corrupted, then everything in this area, every plant, every creature, and every person will soon become... It is an ancient plant, a strangler. It's been here from the beginning. It's the lifeblood of the forest in this area. I don't think so. We must consider the significance of the Green Pact as a whole. At its core, it's a covenant in which we protect the Green and the Green protects us. Not without assistance. After we've killed it, you must remove its heart. We may be able to use that.
Again.
Here in the Shadowwood, you will bring it.
And we find ourselves here once again. It's so unnatural. It makes me feel queasy. The eldest's heart must be the nexus. We have no choice. Though it sounds as if we risk handling the eldest's heart back over to the enemy. Perhaps, though, we might also purge the trees in the forest. The taint came from the eldest, but it has undoubtedly spread to the spirits of the trees themselves. If we can slay... The heart's energy could help you slay the tree spirits, but I'm actually not sure that would be a good idea. If we use the heart this way, it will be corrupted. It would destroy any chance of using it to grow a replacement for the eldest. Thank you for understanding. I do not wish to make this any harder, but I feel that compromising the eldest's heart would be wrong.
almost had that.
wasn't easy, but we did it. We stopped the blight from spreading, defeated Naaman's servant, and we still have the heart we can use to... Thankfully, your efforts within the Shadowwood saved many of them. But there is still much corruption.
I want to drop some of this stuff off at a bank already.
What is it?
The Divines walked at your side at... Most Altmer wouldn't.
Oh, wait. It's because I, it's just got the same design.
Strange happenings in the court of the Wilder King. Did you hear?
More Wilder King nonsense?
No nonsense. This is real. They say an Altmer girl saved his life and then took his place.
You are too gullible.
Keep those weapons sheathed.
Thank you.
elf queen.
Lay aside ancient enmity.
The best woodcraft.
Equipment is at a premium.
Greetings, comrade.
My sweet love, she waits for me to storm and shine.
What do you want?
Ja!
Balinwood is a...
This, until next time.
Yes?
Now, where did he run off to? Well, aren't you the bold one, running around this part of the forest? You've got to be either fearless or just plain foolhardy. Ah, yes, you're the one he mentioned. He'll be glad you're here. The Veiled Heritants were one thing, but the undead are too much. Their Blackroot clan, they were a cruel lot even when they were living, and now they're even worse. Don't ask me. We're at a standstill as far as I'm concerned. You know, he comes and goes. Oh, yeah, there he is.
Did she tell you? One of the greatest mysteries of Valenwood has finally been solved. Decades of conflicting rumors.
Yes, once again the work of Naaman's Shade and the Veiled Heritance.
And yes, I do realize we need to return them to rest, but I'm hoping we can uncover more about what happened here while... The Blackroot Clan warriors are even more bloodthirsty in death than they were in life. But there are also other spirits here, glimmers from the past, crying out for help. I think they're trying...
Good to see you.
Look for the glimmers of the past I spoke of. Hopefully they will help us figure out how to put the Blackroot Clan back to rest.
General Malgoth and the rest of the Black Root troops are almost upon us.
No! That plan is madness!
Silence, Glonir. Our sacrifice today will ensure our sister villages live on.
Elfirion, General Malgoth and the rest of the Black Root troops are almost upon us.
Here's another scene. Let's watch.
Elfie, I can't do this. I'm scared. I don't want to die.
It's all right, Glenril. The poison itself is slow. The Black Root will have cut our throats long before you felt its effects. Here, we'll drink it together, and I'll fight by your side till the end.
Until the end.
Now, to battle! The last of them, General. The village is clear.
An easy victory. Valaine is the first to fall, but there will be more. Now, per the meat mandate, let us feast on the fallen. Prepare the cave temple. It's a suitable place for a celebration.
Spirits, I have to wonder. Look, another one.
General Morgoth, the troops, half of them are dead. The other half...
are dying, including us. This is poison. The villagers poisoned themselves to poison us.
What do you mean?
The meat mandate, you idiot. Eltharion knew she couldn't win on the field, but she'll still manage victory. To the Nereid Temple. Perhaps we can beg a cure.
Here's another scene. Let's
rise,
watch.
My soldiers. Back to your bodies and take
Why
up arms.
Why do you command us from the ooze?
A powerful one, unknown to me, has stolen my bow. It invoked the right of theft and commanded we march against the Dominion.
By your command.
We should go to the cave temple of the Nereid. What a sacrifice! To think the villagers actually poisoned themselves in order to poison the Blackroot clan. It may be morbid, but it's also brilliant. From what I gathered, one of Naaman's servants has stolen General Malgoth's bow and compels the Blackroot clan to fight by the right of theft. What we need to do is steal the General's bow back, and then we can release him from his vows. We must rely on the scenes of the past. After being poisoned, General Malgoth went to the Nereid Temple. It's likely he died. Be wary in there. Desperation turns enemies into allies. The villagers knew General Malgoth and the Blackroot clan were going to attack, and they knew they couldn't win. Likely they asked the Nereids for help. Of course, Malgoth sought to unite all the Bosmer under his leadership. He led the Blackroot clan to conquer much of Valenwood during the Bosmer tribal wars. Then, one day, the Bosmer have always been free peoples, bound only to the Green. Rarely have the tribes united under singular leadership, although for a period many, like Malgoth, tried. Most of the so-called wars were not fought at all. Yes, General Malgoth had traveled far and wide. He had seen the greatness that comes to those who conquer, because it's in their nature. As barbaric as it seems. Apparently so, though the tactics they embrace sound more like a Nereid. For General Malgoth, that's apparently the case. I'd say this is a perverted case. The value that Malgoth, as barbaric as it seems, many clans still lived by the old traditions during the Bosmer tribal wars. Mind you, they didn't consume the bodies of the dead because they enjoyed the taste. It was a matter of tradition.
You would steal that which has already been stolen, then enter the Shadowwood and seek it, though you will find only death. Come face me if it's the bow you desire. The bow is a boon to our army. You will not have it.
We're back in the Shadowwood. I had hoped not to visit here again. But if this is where he is holding the general's bow, I don't know. We'll have to search until we find it, though. In the meantime, however, do you recall the glimmers of the past we saw? It's the shadow rifts that bind them here. From this side, you only need to touch the rifts to close them. Good luck. I'll see you by the stones.
hope you've prepared for undead.
Ifrit, smile on you. You closed the rifts that bound us here. You must stop that shade, though. Thank you. And thank you again for releasing us from his grasp. To be pulled back from the rest of... Yes, I suppose there is. I can give you a shield that will protect you from harm while you remain in the Shadow Wood. Good luck.
Naaman warned me about you, and I prepared. You will die, and then you will serve us.
No!
That was a harrowing experience all around. I'm glad it's over. Yes, and since you have succeeded in stealing it, it falls on you to invoke the right of theft. The compassionate choice would be to release the general and his army, to allow them to return to their rest. But if you prefer, you might ask...
So it's true then? You have retreated?
My father told me, you will find your bow in an animal's bone. Before it's even carved, you will see it. Mammoth's tusk. Extraordinarily difficult to make a good bow out of, but it was just like he said. I saw it, and I knew... You want... I've misheard you. I thought you said leave. But we don't deserve rest.
You released him. I think that was the right thing to do. Since you already freed the village's spirit, we've done all we can here. But it's clear that Naaman still seeks to harm Valenwood, so our work is not finished. I suggest we spread out and search for signs of darkness. When Aurea... Unless you have questions for me, I will soon be on my way. We should both search the forest for other signs of Naaman's corruption. I fear at some point. A spiritual prison of a sort. Bosmer who break their oath to the Green Pact go there when they die, to reflect for an eternity. There's a place called Owls, where we bring the bodies of Oathbreakers. Some think it's a physical link to the Ooze.
Okay, that's a good spot to leave it there. If you're watching this on YouTube, please like and subscribe. If you're watching on Twitch, please consider following. If you're watching this on YouTube and you want to check out the Twitch stream live, the link should be in the description below, or you can check me out at twitch.tv/whatelse96.
Something's changed.
Should be on tomorrow. Till next time, see you later.